Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and AirPods Pro have recently been getting developer betas, and now AirPods Pro Beta 2 is now available. Now, this update finally has something new in it. I didn't make a video about Beta 1 because there was nothing new. With Beta 2, there's actually a new feature enabled, so I'll talk about that in a moment. But first, I wanted to show you how to install the betas. Now, this is for developers only, so you'll need a developer account, as it will not be available to public beta testers, at least right now that we're aware of. You'll also need to keep in mind that you need not only your AirPods Pro, but they need to be charged to 100%. Once they're charged to 100%, you'll also need an iPhone running the latest version of iOS 15, and also a Mac that's running Xcode betas as well. As long as you have all of those things, you can install this. But I would not recommend installing this, even if you're a developer, unless you want to try out the features or develop for it, because there is no way to downgrade. So in order to downgrade, you would have to give these to Apple, similar to what you have to do with an Apple Watch if you're on the beta program. So they can send this in and get it downgraded. The same is true with AirPods Pro. Now, the first thing we need to do to install this is make sure, like I said, we have an iPhone, and on the iPhone, you'll need to install a beta profile, similar to when you installed the public beta of iOS 15 or developer beta. You'll download that from the developer portal, and once you log in, you need to go to the More section to download that. Once you have the beta profile downloaded, you'll see profile downloaded in your settings. We'll tap on that. Then we'll install the beta profile. You can see it says AirPods Pro Seed 2021. We'll tap on install, put in our passcode. Then we'll have to tap on install in the upper right, agree again by tapping install on the bottom, and now it's installed the beta profile. So we're good to go here. The next thing we need to do is we need to connect our AirPods Pro to our iPhone. So make sure they're connected, open them up, connect them. Make sure they're connected to your iPhone, and you'll see it's connected here. We can also see that under Bluetooth where they're connected under AirPods Pro. So we're good to go there. Now, the next thing we need to do is we need to plug in our iPhone to our Mac. So we'll go ahead and do that. We'll plug in the iPhone to the Mac with a lightning cable. And then on the Mac, once the iPhone is trusted to the Mac, go ahead and open your Xcode beta. Again, that's available in the developer portal. Once that's open, all we have to do is open it, and that's it. Now, once you've opened Xcode and your phone is still connected to the computer, go into settings, and in settings, scroll down until you see developer. Developer will show up now that you're plugged into Xcode. Tap on developer, scroll all the way to the bottom, and you'll see it says AirPods testing, pre-release beta firmware. Tap on this option, and then at the top it says Aaron's AirPods Pro. If you have other AirPods Pro, they'll be listed here. Go ahead and turn on the switch. Now, for me, this may or may not crash, and it did crash. And if you're having this problem, you can fix this by going into your settings, going to General, going down to Transfer or Reset iPhone. Tap on reset and reset all settings. Now, this will wipe all of your network settings and many other options that you might have set. So in order to get this to work properly, you may have to do this if you're on some of the latest betas. I've had to do this, as you can see, so let's go ahead and do that. It won't wipe the phone. It will just reset all of the settings. So I'll go ahead and put in my passcode. We'll reset all settings. And if this is something you're not comfortable doing, then you may want to skip installing the AirPods Pro beta until maybe the next beta of iOS 15 is out and it doesn't crash any longer. So I'll wait for this to reset and we'll try it again. Now the phone is rebooted. You can see my wallpaper has reset. I had to reconnect to Wi-Fi and reset up Face ID. So I wouldn't recommend doing this unless you really want to try the beta software. But if you have to reset this, we should now be able to enable the developer option. And so I've got the AirPods Pro connected to my iPhone. If we go into Bluetooth, you can see that it says connected. And now if we go back and scroll down to developer, there it is. And again, we're still connected to the computer and we have Xcode running. Go into developer, scroll to the bottom, and then tap on pre-release beta firmware. Under that, you'll see that it's turned on because I was able to turn this on before. Now it will actually work. Now, the only thing is there's no way to force this to update. What you have to do is just close the case. And so normally what I do is I plug in the AirPods Pro And then it says closing the case will trigger the install of the beta profile. Then it can take up to 24 hours to update. So that's the unfortunate thing with AirPods Pro firmware updates, whether they're public or not, there's no way to force it. You basically have to set it next to your phone, close the AirPods Pro, it triggers the install of the profile, and come back later and hope that it's updated. And that's all you can do. So once it's updated, we'll come back and take a look at what's new. Now the AirPods Pro have finally updated, and it took anywhere between 20 to 24 hours for it to install. There's no way to force the install where there's a button like you can with iOS 15 betas, unfortunately. Hopefully they add that in the future. At some point I needed to use these before the update had installed. I put them in my ears, used them for maybe a half hour, put them back in the case, connected it to the iPhone, put them both on the charger, and came back an hour or two later and they had finally updated. And the way you check for the update is based off the version or build number. You can check that in two places. Go into your settings, and in settings, it's either under general and about, or you can just go to Bluetooth. And then under Bluetooth, you can see here, it says AirPods Pro, they're connected. Tap on the I, and under the I, if we scroll to the bottom, at the bottom, you'll see it says version 4A362B. That's how you know you're on the latest beta, as that's the current build number. So that's the only way to know that it's been updated. Now it adds a new feature once you have this update. So we'll go back into our settings. Now back under settings, if we scroll down to accessibility, under accessibility, if we go down to AirPods, your AirPods need to be connected. Under AirPods, you'll see select your AirPods, Aaron's AirPods Pro. And under this setting, we have audio accessibility settings. Go into audio accessibility settings, go to headphone accommodations, and then do a custom audio setup. After you've done the custom audio setup, what it does is plays some sounds and understands how well you can hear or can't, and then it adds a new option for you. So I couldn't find the option until this was updated, and the new option has to do with being able to hear conversations, or it's something that Apple showed off around the iOS 15 announcement, where they talked about using your AirPods to boost conversation and be able to hear. Maybe if you have difficulty hearing, it sort of focuses voice into your ears. And this is a great feature. So if we take one of the AirPods out, I'll put one in my ear. The way you access this after it's been set up is you go into your control center, and then you have the ear. And you need to add this in your control center settings. But if you go into the ear, you'll see that we now have conversation boost at the bottom. We can tap on this, turn it off, and it won't boost the conversation, or we can turn it back on. And now we have the option to change the overall settings for not only amplification, but balance, darker or brighter, and ambient noise reduction. So if there's too much ambient noise, we can just turn that up and it removes the ambient noise. So this is a new feature that's been added with the AirPods Pro, and something that's coming to everyone a little bit later once iOS 15 launches. So that's the main update in this update. There are no other updates, but the conversation boost works really well. I've tested it out in my home and was able to hear people from quite some distance away, depending on what my settings were. So it's great to have this option finally, and it seems to work really well. And again, this is a beta, so I wouldn't necessarily recommend it for everyone, but it is an option if you want to try these out, and you know that you cannot downgrade your AirPods Pro without bringing them to Apple and then having them send them in and downgrade them that way. So there's no way around it. You can't downgrade. So just be aware of that. If there's a problem, you will have to send them to Apple. Now, as far as future updates and future changes with these updates, we don't really know exactly what will be in them, as Apple does not state. They don't even have notes for these updates. So maybe we'll see an update in a week or so. They sort of silently release, and this one actually released quite some time ago and no one really caught it. So it's hard to know if it's updated, because it updates on its own once you have the beta profile installed, and there's just no simple way to know what these updates are. So hopefully one day they'll add some update options, maybe in your settings, just like you update iOS. So it would be great to see that here, but maybe one day we'll see that. Now, as far as the next iOS update, I would expect it as soon as Monday or Tuesday at this point, generally around the 9th or 10th of August. And then maybe we'll have weekly updates after that. And sometime, usually it seems to be on a Friday, they release AirPods Pro updates as well. So maybe this coming Friday, we'll have another version. And if there's something else new in it, I'll be sure to let you know. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.